Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Gina. In this video, we are going to talk about the energy and work, and we are going to look at an example. There are two types of energy, kinetic energy and potential energy. Kinetic energy is the energy that is associated with motion. And the kinetic energy of an object is half times the mass of the object times its speed squared. A unit for energy is joules. From the formula for kinetic energy, we can also derive that joules is the same unit as kilograms times meter squared over second squared. And potential energy is the energy that is associated with possibility to have motion. For example, the gravitational potential energy, or we can denote that as U sub g. The potential energy of an object is the mass times gravitational acceleration times the object's height. If there's no other external forces acting on the system, then the energy is conserved. In other words, the initial energy of a system equals to its final energy. In terms of kinetic and potential energy, conservation of energy is initial kinetic energy plus initial potential energy. Here we focus on the gravitational potential energy. And it equals to the final kinetic energy plus the final gravitational potential energy. However, if there's a force acting on the system, and if this force changed the kinetic energy, we denote the change of kinetic energy as work. And the formula for that is magnitude of force times the distance traveled times cosine theta, where theta is the angle between the force and the displacement. So when there's work from external forces, then the energy is not conserved. So we can rewrite the energy equation as initial energy plus the work done by external forces, and this equals to the final energy. Or in terms of kinetic and potential energy, initial kinetic energy plus initial gravitational potential energy plus the work done by external forces, for example, the friction or air resistance. And this equals to the final energy, which is the final kinetic energy plus the final gravitational potential energy. Now let's look at this example. A ski starts from rest and slides down at 25 degrees incline, and the distance traveled is 90 meters. If the coefficient of friction is 0.1, what is the ski's speed at the base of the incline? And if the snow is level at the foot of the incline and has the same coefficient of friction, how far will the ski travel along the level? Here there are two methods to solve the problem. You can use the kinematic approach or energy method. Kinematic approach means you use Newton's second law and balance the forces to find the acceleration of the object. Then use the kinematic equations to find the final speed or the distance traveled. But here we are going to use the energy method. Let's start with a sketch. So there's an incline and the angle is 25 degrees. And the length of this incline, let's call it capital D, is 90 meters. So there's a ski at the top of an incline and its initial speed is 0. For part A, we want to find the final speed at the bottom of the incline, given that the coefficient of friction is 0.1. And for part B, after the ski is at the foot of the incline, we want to find the distance traveled. Let's define the coordinate. I'm going to use the foot of the incline as y equals to 0, and it's positive upward. So for part A, Here there's friction, which means the energy is not conserved. So we have to use the second energy equation, that is, initial kinetic energy plus initial potential energy plus the work done equals to the final kinetic energy plus final gravitational potential energy. Initially, the ski is not moving, so the initial speed is zero. So initial kinetic energy is zero. And at the bottom of the incline, y equals to zero. So the final gravitational potential energy is zero. Now we are left with three terms. What is the initial gravitational potential energy? It is mass times g times h, where h is the initial height. And the work done, it equals to magnitude of the external force times the distance traveled times cosine theta, where theta is the angle between the force and the displacement. And this equals to the final kinetic energy, that is half times the mass times final speed squared. Now let's find the h and magnitude of friction force. Let's start with h. So we can use the geometry. Sine of 25 is h over capital D. So h is d times sine of 25. Now how about the magnitude of friction force? Let's draw the forces on the diagram. So there's gravity force and the normal force, and the friction will be in opposite direction than the displacement. So it will be pointing upward along the incline. Now if we define the x and y as along the plane and perpendicular to x, then F net in y using Newton's second law, it equals to mass times acceleration in y. But acceleration in y is zero. So the normal force minus y component of gravity, that is mg times cosine of 25, it equals to zero. And we know that the kinetic friction equals to the coefficient of friction times the normal force. Then we can substitute the normal force from this equation into the kinetic friction. So this equals to the coefficient times mass times g times cosine of 25. Let's put this in the energy equation. So the energy equation becomes mass times g times initial height, which is distance traveled times sine of 25. Then plus magnitude of friction, that is the coefficient times mass times g times cosine of 25. Then times capital D and cosine theta. And theta is 180 because the displacement will be in the opposite direction than the friction. And this equals to half times mass times final speed squared. The mass can be canceled out on both sides. Then we can isolate for the final speed, which is the square root of 2 times the left-hand side. And let's substitute the numbers. Final speed squared equals to 2 times 9.8 times capital D is 90 meters times sine of 25. Then, since cosine of 180 is negative 1, so the second term would be minus, the coefficient is 0.1 times 9.8 times cosine of 25 and times distance traveled, d, 90 meters. Then you take the square root of that, you'll find that final speed at the bottom of the incline is around 24.20 meter per second. Now let's look at part B. Again, we are going to use the energy method. So initial kinetic energy plus initial potential energy plus the work done by external forces equals to final kinetic energy plus final gravitational potential energy. Here the initial point will be at the bottom of the incline, and the final point will be where the ski stops. So where the ski stops, its velocity will be zero. So final kinetic energy is zero. And the ski is at y equals to zero for initial and final. So there is no gravitational potential energy here. So we are left with initial kinetic energy, that is half mv squared. And this equals to the work done by the friction, that is minus magnitude of friction times distance traveled, and this equals to zero. For this part, the ski is already at a horizontal plane, so the normal force and gravity force, they will cancel each other out in the y direction, and friction force will be pointing to the left. So the normal force equals to mg, and magnitude of kinetic friction would be coefficient times mg. So the energy equation becomes half times the mass times initial speed squared equals coefficient times mg times d. The initial speed here would be the final speed we found from part A. Now let's isolate for the distance traveled. The mass can be canceled out. So d equals to half times initial speed is 24.20 over coefficient is 0.1 times 9.8. And we get the distance traveled at the level is around 198.8 meters. And that is the end of the video. If you like my videos, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.